About halfway between Dublin and Cork, you'll find the Irish town of Kilkenny. And one of the most impressive sights here is St. Canice's Cathedral, constructed in the 13th century. At St. Canice's, you'll find a collection of historic tombs and grave markers, including one belonging to a banker named Jose de Kyteler. He died in 1280, and his surname, though spelled differently, is displayed less than half a mile down the road on Kilkenny's oldest tavern. Welcome to Kyteler's Inn. Jose de Kyteler built this place as his family home in 1263, and his enterprising daughter, Alice Kyteler, turned it into a tavern.
Alice was, by all accounts, very beautiful, very influential in the community, and quite a catch for any gentleman.
But despite her bright backstory, Alice's future takes a dark turn. It's 1280, and Alice is the medieval it girl when she marries wealthy Kilkenny merchant William Outlaw. They have a son, and everything seems to be working out just hunky-dory. Then, without warning, William dies of an unexplained illness. But not one to wither on the vine, Alice eventually remarries again and again. Obviously, she has a type, because all three of Alice's husbands are old and rich, and they all end up dying under mysterious circumstances. Another thing the men all have in common? The same beneficiary in their wills. Go ahead, take a guess who.
Not only when those husbands died, but their children, they did not inherit one red cent. All of the wealth, the estate, the money went to Alice.
Fast forward to 1324. Alice Kyteler is playing doting wife to her ailing fourth husband when his children arrive to pay him a visit.
They took one look at their father in the bed, and they nearly died. We are told that he was totally emaciated, deprived of his nails, and his hair had fallen out.
Sensing something is amiss, his kids take action.
They accused Alice of sorcery and witchcraft and heresy.
They claim that in the basement of Kyteler's Inn, Alice and her loyal servant, Petronilla de Meath, brew magical potions, sacrifice animals, and even commune with a demon. That part of the legend looms large for Kyteler's current owner, Nicky Flynn.
Fun fact, Nicky is the great-great-granddaughter of author Charles Dickens, so she has a natural flair for the dramatic. You'll see what I mean.
While working late one night, Nicky claims she walked out of the office and then returned to find the door had been locked from the inside.
When we eventually did break our way back in, the key was on the other side. It had to be Alice.
But why would Alice Kyteler haunt this place? Well, some believe she may be looking to right some old wrongs. Back in 1324, Alice's stepchildren take their accusations up the street to St. Canice's Cathedral, straight to the attention of the bishop, Richard Deladred.
Richard Deladred was actually an English Franciscan who had trained on the continent in, of all things, sorcery. So here was a bishop itching for a witch, and now he reckoned he had one.
Deladred calls for Alice's arrest, but Alice has friends in high places. And in the end, it's not Alice who's arrested. It's the bishop. But the bishop can pull strings too. After being locked up for 17 days, he has his arrest declared unlawful and is released from prison. Now, he's determined to exact his revenge by scaring the local officials into arresting Alice Kyteler.
This time, he went gung-ho for Alice, and one of the charges that he brought against her went as follows. In order to inflict death or disease on the body, she made powders and ointments containing certain horrible worms, curious herbs and dead men's nails, which she cooked in a vessel made from the skull of a decapitated thief.
Alice's powerful friends back away, saying they can't help anymore because the Pope himself is now backing the bishop. To avoid capture, she must leave Ireland at once.
Alice Kyteler slipped quietly out of this country and was never heard of again. She literally vanished without a trace.
And while hardly anyone today believes that Alice was a witch, she probably was a murderer. Alice wasn't putting Eye of Newt or Wings of Fairy in her husband's meals, but their illnesses did point to the ingestion of a common chemical that can cause nausea, vomiting, hair loss, and yes, even death.
We now know in hindsight that these are classic symptoms of arsenic poisoning.
With Alice nowhere to be found, the authorities instead apprehend her servant, Petronilla. And under torture, she confesses to all sorts of sorcery. On November 3rd, 1324, in front of an angry mob, Petronilla de Meve becomes one of the very first people burned at the stake for the crime of heresy. Predating the Salem witch trials by more than 350 years, Petronilla's gruesome death ushers in a sad chapter in world history. Over the next 500 years, it's believed that as many as 50,000 other accused witches were executed. At Kyteler's Inn, the alleged presence of Alice's ghost is a reminder of Ireland's grim past. So Nikki Flynn says she's careful to give the spirit plenty of space.
When Alice is happy, the house is happy.
Now, we will never know for sure if Alice found redemption for her sins, but there are some villains who did manage to change their wicked ways. 1,100 miles to the south in Malaga, Spain, stands an unassuming church where one bloodthirsty bandit experienced a life-altering conversion. The Mediterranean Sea meets Spain's southern shores at Costa del Sol, the coast of the sun. The region's capital is Malaga, one of the oldest cities in the world. And over Malaga's rich 2,800-year history, few events are more talked about than an incident said to have occurred two centuries ago in the chapel Ermita de Zamaria. The chapel's focal point is this wooden statue of the Virgin Mary. But unlike most carved idols, she's cloaked in actual fabric garments. And unlike conventional depictions of Mary, she wears a red rose, speared to her cloak with a dagger. For this unusual adornment, Christianity's most beloved saint can thank one of Spain's most notorious sinners. It's 1844. Gangs of thieves are terrorizing Malaga. Among the bandits, there's one who is the most feared of all. His name is Cristobal Ruiz Bermudez, and he works solo, usually targeting the rich. He's known not only for his debonair style, but also for a track record of ruthless killings.
Cristobal Ruiz Bermudez was a heartless bandit. There are some accounts that he was a champion of the people, but I suspect those reports came from those who benefit from his thievery.
Eager to crack down on the rampant crime, Malaga authorities send out the civil guard. Cristobal is feeling the heat. The prudent strategy would be to take refuge in the hills, but Malaga holds one attraction that he just can't resist. He's in love with a señorita named Maria and wants her as his bride. As a pledge of her devotion, she gives him a white rose.